BBC News, New York.
Chinese leader Xi Jinping is in Moscow for talks with his counterpart Vladimir Putin ahead of the G20 summit in Germany later this week. There is plenty to discuss among the two leaders. The two countries are major trading partners, and they're expected to sign a number of deals at this meeting. But even though China's One Belt, One Road plan goes through much of Central Asia, Russia will largely miss out on the economic benefits. Earlier, I spoke with Tatiana Sheremetyeva from the Russian Asian Business Union. I asked her if the One Belt, One Road initiative will cause any friction between the two leaders.
Russia doesn't participate exactly in this initiative, but it's highly supported because it's going along with Russian-led Eurasian European Union, which consists of Russia, Armenia, Belarus, Kazakhstan. So I think the initiative of two countries, they're going much along because both of them want to create like free trade zone, which will contribute to all the Eurasia continent.
But do you think that China will also be losing by bypassing a large chunk of Russia?
I wouldn't say China will lose something, you know, because even we know from the gas contract between Russia and China, both countries benefiting a lot, yeah, because Russia allow, you know, they're building a lot of like gas pipes, you know, to sell their gas to China on very competitive price. So I'm sure the two countries can arrange, you know, some very good pricing for both of them.
And despite this situation between Russia and China at the moment, trade is up by over 26% between the two countries. What is driving this higher trade?
How to say? Trade consists, now they develop a lot of investment, they develop a lot of like machinery, we finance and mass media and education. So many different fields are start to develop. And I know just now where President Xi, you know, he's coming to Moscow to discuss their plan of mutual bilateral relations for 2017-2020. Because after 2020, the trade should reach $200 billion US dollars.